Hi guys, a few days ago OC50 got a nice set of vintage hard drives, so I was jealous and I wanted to have some too. I went on eBay and I found this for €5. We have here a modified Seagate ST4766E MFM hard drive. I do not know the capacity for now, so it is from around 1993, but this specific one is very interesting because it is a custom thing. So we have a mix of original hard drive parts and added stuff for a specific purpose, it seems. You can see here you have the original front plate of the drive, which would be in the face of your IBM PC computer with a activity LED. You have here the original controller PCB with the side structural parts of the drive. In fact it is all. And here on the top, you have an added spindle motor controller. Usually the spindle motor should be connected here, I believe, but this wire harness comes from the spindle motor, goes to this PCB, and here we have this flex PCB going back to the original spindle motor plug here. Here we have the IDS connector for the IDS control motor and the read-write IDS link. But it is heavily modified at this point. As you can see, there is a piece of PCB sticking out here, and here is what we have. So it looks like RAM sticks, but no, it is not RAM sticks. It is some kind of read-write amplifier. It is analog circuitry. You can see lots of passive parts. And the ICs here are from the XR brand. So it is a brand of ICs specialized in hard drive read-write IDS circuits. So you can see here this flex PCB coming from inside the drive. You have a number of small PCBs, and the chips we have on them are XR1172D. It is a read-write IDS preamplifier chips. It seems it goes, you have preamplifiers here, then more amplifying or signal processing circuitry here, I believe. We have two IDS connectors here, and also two IDS connectors here. And the flex circuits from the IDS. So I believe this may be the IDS motor control, because this wire comes from this motor driver PCB. You can see the driver transistors here. So here we must have connection to the IDS motor, and here we have the IDS output going to all this circuitry. And this flex circuit goes also back to the regular controller PCB. So it is really weird. Why do you need all this circuitry for the read-write IDS? I have no clue at all. So I did Google the different numbers I did find on the thing, but I found no information. You have here assembly number on this PCB 88-K140-01. So one interesting thing, you have here a test sticker tested in 25 February 1993 and AMO initials. It must be the name of a guy, so if you know him, you can ask him maybe. And nothing else. So this kind of sticker, I did already see it onto a military grade electronics. So it is quite interesting. And also there is this kind of control, quality control stamps. It looks like almost military control stamps, not sure. So it must be for some kind of very special purpose application. So you will notice that there is no way the hard drive fits in a regular space for it in a computer, because there is this PCB on the side here sticking out, and of course the big PCB here with the it stick out from the front plate. The attachment point you have, I think you have these four screw holes here, but this wire harness is in the way, so it is quite weird. Here at the back side, I believe we are missing an original PCB. Maybe the original motor control PCB was here and was removed and replaced by this one. Because if you look at this flex circuit here, in fact, the way it is folded, if you unplug it, it should come here, just in the correct spot for a PCB here. And we have the other motor control plug here. So I think it is reasonable to believe we are missing a PCB here. But I did a search eBay for similar kind of hard drive in order to see if I can get photos of it, but I did not find any Seagate of the same model for on eBay for now. So I will have to wait and check back from time to time. Here we have a small header connector. I believe it is for factory test and firmware programming. We have here the regular MFM edge connectors. Here we have a spot for termination resistors, I believe, but it is not fitted. Here we have a regular Molex plug. So I did try to power it up, but it does nothing. Just the LED here flashes a couple times and it is all. So I do not know if either my power supply is not beefy enough, if it is waiting for some control signals to really start, or if there is something wrong in it. So one thing wrong I know of is this this flex circuit here is a little damaged, and there is a couple tracks cut, but it is not the big beefy tracks. So it should maybe, I think it is for speed feedback or something like this, but not for the main power to the motor. You can see here, I believe, a big fat PCBs inside the PCB, fat copper tracks. Okay, so it will be all for now, because I have no other information about this thing. As you can see, it is really, really weird. You can notice the socketed ICs here. The number on them is, it is from Texas Instruments, AM 26LS31CN. This one, we have a PAL here, the other are the same ones. So this looks like more analog than digital board. This is really, really weird. Why do you need so much analog stuff? As you can see, lots of passives. Okay, so thanks for watching. Bye bye.